welcome to Classic Car Culture. I am Christine Louise, and we are here in Bodega, California, for the first annual event, Valley of the Buzzards, which is hosted by Marc of Clutch Monkey, and acts as a benefit for Lee Bender, who was hit by an uninsured motorist. So before we go to the Valley of the Buzzards, I want to take a look and see what this town has to offer. Church that was used to film Hitchcock's The Birds. Marc and Jena of Clutch Monkey, and I'm very, very excited. It's good to see you again. Last time I saw you was Born Free 4, yeah, right? Yeah. Now you've opened up your home and your land to house the Valley of the Buzzards. Now how did this come about?
Well, we did a very successful party in Santa Rosa, which is about 20 miles east of here, last year, called the Dust Up.
Right.
And we had an amazing representation of Oakland and San Francisco and Sacramento, just great bikes from all over the area. A lot of fun. It was sort of like totally punk rock, no county involved, no ABC involved, great bands. Two of them are playing tonight.
Oh, what are the bands?
Tiger Honeypot and Pete and Repeat. So those are the two bands that played last year. And then we've got two additionals tonight that we're really excited about. So we moved to Bodega since we had that party. And so we figured, you know what the fuck, right? It's a town that is revered and sort of remembered for Hitchcock's 1963 awesome film, one of my favorite Hitchcockian films ever, The Birds. And so we figured we'd sort of play, you know, the theme and title around what's going on.
And what kind of attendance are you expecting?
You know, it's small. You know, we sold some tickets. It's really a, you know, it's really a benefit for a friend of ours,
Lee Bender,
who is who was injured in a motorcycle accident by an uninsured motorist.
Right.
And he was actually en route because he's a hobbyist with photography, and he was en route to shoot a Clutch Monkey vest when he got hit. So this is the least.
But he's doing fine though now, right?
It's the least we can do. He's doing fine. He's walking. He's super stoked. He's having fun outside right now.
Nice. Well, why don't you show me outside?
I'd love
to. Let's see. Yes, absolutely.
Yeah,
come on.
Yeah.
I'm excited to see. This is great. So how long did it take you to like organize this?
You know, we've been organizing this now for on and off. I mean, it's been more off than on, to be honest with you.
Do you plan on doing this every year?
Yeah, this will be the first annual.
Oh, awesome. Yeah. Now, what sponsors do you have this year?
We've got Build Well. That's our head sponsor.
Okay.
We're really super stoked that Bill came through. So we've got them. We've got Throttle Addiction. We've got Harold's Ironworks. We've got Old Stuff. You know, Mike and his family at Old Stuff. And a sea of others. You know.
Yeah, I love that bus.
Yeah,
nice.
It's a retired 1966 Greyhound that we gutted.
And you redid the inside, right?
Redid the inside. It's kind of like a 1950s supper club. Sort of like built-in couch, bar, you know, hardwood floors, that kind of thing. It's got a great sound system in it. Yeah. So yeah. Orchid is using it as their sort of like chill space.
Well, thank you so much. This is so awesome. It looks like it's going to be a huge success.
Cool. I think so too.
Yes.
Yeah. Right on. Glad you're here.
And how
You have a family, right? You have
kids. Yeah, three kids.
A husband, and you guys are working on, what are you guys working on? Your vest.
We're working on the Clutch Monkey vest. We've got the ladies vest just came out. We're doing a new jewelry line. It's going to be coming out soon. We have
something. I want something. I want a vest. I think I'm going to have to sneak one home.
And I can't wait to see what happens tonight.
Yeah, thanks.
I'll see you later.
Okay.
So much.
Bye.
Big brother, which is going to be a 16-ounce.
That's right.
It's going to be a 16-ounce Rockstar competitor.
Watch out, Rockstar.
But Rockstar, this is a real Rockstar, so.
All right, let's try it. Let's hear it.
There you go. Chug it down.
And it keeps you up for days. Not hours.
Just spit it out.
I don't want to be up for days. I'm trying to get some rest.
I'm kidding.
But is it really?
It'll make you skateboard 10 times better than you've ever skated in your life.
Is that so?
It'll turn you into a professional skateboarder overnight.
Okay, yeah. Then I'm gonna drink some.
Yeah. If you're into that.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, so tell us.
I'm Kirk Taylor from Custom Design Studios. I roll out of Nevada, California, NorCal represent. I do bikes for a lot of different types of people. Most of my customers are blue collar.
Right.
But some of the customers that I've had over the years have been guys like James Hetfield from Metallica, Neil Sean from the band Journey, Robert Trujillo, the bass player, through his suicidal tendencies.
How long have you been doing that?
Since 1988. Yeah, my dad started his own machine shop in 1970. He was doing extended spray and girder front ends for the motorcycle. So I grew up around hot rods and choppers as a little kid and guns. Ended up turning it into a career.
Awesome, on the machine shop. Did you work on cars too or just bikes?
Mostly on bikes. The car projects that I take on are primarily personal, or if I think it's the cars are my passion and the bikes
customer?
Are my profession.
Oh, okay.
So I got a 63 Rivi and a 1964 nice. Sunliner convertible.
Ooh,
the Sunliner's
sexy.
Actually out here on the side of the road right now.
Oh, we're gonna have to go check that out. So I'm here with Lee Bender and Cassandra. Lee Bender was a sponsored skateboarder, right?
Yes.
For how many years have you been skating?
21.
And then what made you stop?
In 07, I was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis.
Wow.
So just the symptoms from that kind of took the ability to skate away. It hasn't gotten worse, but it hasn't gotten any better.
Okay.
But then once I couldn't skate, I had to funnel all that energy and time into something else. So
bikes became your passion?
Bikes, yeah.
Right, and so you won an award at Born Free. What did you win an award for?
Yeah, my buddy Josh Kirpius designated me in a sense, I guess.
It was the Born Free Award.
Yeah, it was the Born Free Award, and he chose me for it because he won it last year. And it's an award that's passed down every year.
Oh.
Unfortunately, I was in line getting a drink, and I didn't
hear. And you missed it?
Missed the whole thing. But I ended up with a trophy an hour later.
Right. And so we're here at this event that acts as a fundraiser for you as well. So what happened? You went down on your bike? When did that happen? And
March 2nd, a 23-year-old girl pulled out in front of me. She admitted to speeding out in front of me to try to get in front of me first. And I hit her. I don't know how fast I was going. I don't even remember leaving my house. And I woke up in the hospital and had two broken knees, broken wrist, broken elbow, two broken fingers, broken rib, partially collapsed lung, and 15 staples in my head.
Oh my God.
28 staples in my head. Yeah.
How long was that recovery?
4 months, four and a half.
Just about.
Yeah, a little over 4 months.
And you were with him during that recovery?
Yeah, all along.
Yeah, she was there, quit her job, made every meal.
Oh, wow.
Did everything she possibly could for me.
Maybe that'll work.
Yeah.
It was great though, the first thing, Lee and I met riding motorcycles together. That's how we became friends initially.
How long have you been riding?
Since I was a little girl, since I was 5 or 6.
Awesome.
Yeah. Love it. But yeah, the first thing when I got to the hospital, I rushed over there, found out from friends. I was there like an hour, maybe so, after he'd been admitted to the hospital, and he's like laid up in the bed, barely coherent. And I got there and I told him, you know, I'm here. And he said, you know, call my dad, call my mom, let him know I'm okay. But also, I need you to find me a 21-inch front wheel and 39mm forks.
What? While you're in the hospital?
He's like, I need new parts because I need to fix my motorcycle.
She was uninsured, had expired tags.
Wow.
And admitted fault on site, and a cop let her drive home with no ticket.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Yeah. She's 23 and she trims weed for work. So she has no garnishable wages, so even if I sued, I can't get anything from her.
Yeah.
Even if we could find a lawyer that would take the case.
Yeah. Wow. So on top of all the injuries and everything, then you have this like huge hospital bill to cover.
And a total bike as well.
Yeah.
So what kind of support have you gotten?
I've had a lot of friends do fundraisers, even just donations.
Mm-hmm.
I was selling prints, some photos that I shot. But the main thing so far has been some friends made some stickers.
Okay.
Said, support Lee Bender, or I support Lee Bender, or something.
Yes,
like
I
that.
Saw those.
Lee Bender is a friend of mine.
Yeah, there was two of them. It was one sticker of each of the two designed, and then a drawing that was what I thought my perspective from the wreck, mid-wreck was, like mid-flight through the air. And we sold those two stickers in the drawing for $5 each. One guy from Japan that I've never met was sent me a message on PayPal, and it just said, here's $500, I only want two stickers.
That's amazing. So you've kind of touched a lot of people. I mean, a lot of people that you don't even know, maybe through skateboarding or friends of friends.
Yeah.
And so you'd say that like kind of nationwide, there's people that are helping you as well?
Worldwide. There was a ton of support from Germany and Italy and Brazil, just all over the world, all over the globe. Marc and his wife Jenna put this event on as well, and, you know, lent their property and all this time, energy, and it's pretty amazing. It's great for Northern California motorcycle scene.
Absolutely. Yeah. And it's good to know that you're loved worldwide.
Yeah,
that people, I mean, that's pretty amazing.
It's
that
unreal.
Yeah, that people from all over the world are supporting you, or, you know, care and, you know, want to help out.
Totally.
I think
it's
pretty amazing and says something about you. For sure.
Thanks.
I think so. And I want to touch on really quick that you said you're a photographer, or you dabble.
Mm-hmm. I shoot photos.
You're so humble.
Maybe. He's a great writer too. There's his other blog, his website, onesickrace.com.
Onesickrace.com. So check out his work.
Yeah.
Not updated that often, I'm sorry.
Okay. Yeah. All right, get on the ball, okay?
Yeah.
Update your website so we can check out your work.
Will do.
All right, perfect. Thank you. Raging, and I'm exhausted. I want to say a big, huge thank you to Marc and Jena for opening up their home and land and putting on this amazing event. I had a blast. I hope you guys did too. I met some really amazing people and got to catch up with old friends. This is Classic Car Culture. I'm Christine Louise. Until next time, bye. Let me